all, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we're carrying on with a Lancaster Bomber. We've got issues 76 and 78. Now these are identical with the parts, ammunition boxes and track system that go into the rear fuselage. They're for the gun turrets, of course. So without further ado, let's have a look at the instructions, see what this fully entails. Here we go. Issue 76. There's the ammunition box, which we've done previously. And this is the track system that we're talking about. It does show it as being airbrushed, but I won't be airbrushing it. There we go. Goes into the rear end of the fuselage there. Makes its way all the way through here. This is two pieces. One butts up to this former here, and then other pieces added, and then little brackets are added onto it as well. And that's two pieces. Then you add the third piece here, which go on this bracket here, and this section with the ammunition boxes. We put two more ammunition boxes here, so we've got a track system here and here on brackets, and then this will flip round, and the ammunition boxes will butt up to the track system. Now you can see the track system there and here. There we go, that's a better picture there. That's the back end of it. And here is the track system connected up from one part of the fuselage to another. And that is one fully completed track system on that side. Now issue 78 is just exactly the same. Ammunition box, track system. There are the two ammunition boxes here. There you can see the brackets here as well, which the track system will rest on. There's four all together. One here and then others interspersed. There we go. There's a second one. Third one we're down here, and the fourth one down at the bottom here, as you can see there. And that is the two track systems here. There you can see the end of them there. That's where the ammunition gets loaded onto the track system from the ammunition boxes. Excellent stuff. Looks very, very fiddly indeed. It is all die cast this, so I'll have to be careful with this, because some of it does break easily, or could break easily, I should say. But we'll just have to check it and file it like I normally do anyway, because they'll probably have rough edges on them anyway. Well, there we go. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. Thank you. Okay, don't. There we go, folks. That is issues 76 and 78 completed. There you can see the two ammunition boxes. One of these boxes was a little bit warped, so the lid won't actually shut. The other one was fine, but it is what it is. It looks, it's still painted up well and it looks good, but the lid just won't go down on it. But it doesn't matter that anyway, because it's not something that's ever going to get used. There's the track system. I did have problems with some of these brackets and the track system as well. This part of the track system is in three pieces anyway, but one of them did break whilst I was filing it down, smoothing it down. But they have glued together perfectly alright. There we go. Turn that around that way. See it better? There we go. And the brackets, well, the brackets never really fit either. But they're quite brittle, So I just did the best I could with them. These brackets on this part of the track system, they just sit on top, so they're just super glued in place. It was just a case of marrying that one up with that one, because this is just two pieces. These two pieces just butt up to this former, just so they look exactly straight, which they actually are. But I did have to file the entrance holes here. There we go, make them bigger. But it looks perfectly good, and I didn't airbrush anything, I just hand painted it all. But it looks excellent. And when you do butt these up, I know we've got these two pieces in the way, but they do, or they should eventually, when they do match up, connect up perfectly all right. They should be all level. It's difficult to show you at the moment. And obviously that part of the track system will go there, like so. Get that into place like that. You can see the stringers all meet up nicely, and you can see the track system meeting up with the ammunition boxes. Brilliant. A lot of detail. There's a lot more detail to be added as well, I think. Yeah, on this section here we got the two hydraulic pumps here. There's another one to be added here on this side. It's a little bit annoying because I could have done that earlier, but anyway, I didn't see it when I was going through the issues. But anyway, that is it. That is 76 and 78 complete. So there we go, issue 76, 78 complete. 77 is the start of the starboard wing, so I'll be doing that along with issue 79, because that's more of the starboard wing. That's why I did these two, because gets the track system out of the way. When I was looking at all the parts, I thought, well, that's going to be fiddly. Like I said, I did have one or two issues with it, but everything seems to be fine, so that's lucky. Bits of glue here and there, but then again, the track system is all glued together anyway, in places. It looks really good. I'm quite chuffed with it actually, and like I said, I didn't airbrush it, I didn't see the point. But anyway, that is it for this, for these two issues. So the next issue is probably be up in a couple of weeks time, but so keep your eyes open for that one. Anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you soon for the next two. Thanks for tuning in and watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.